Hi, welcome to my new video. As I was getting a lot of questions about RailConnect for Office 365 and how to start a trial, I wanted to create a quick video. And in this video, I wanted to guide you through step by step what you need to do to get your RailConnect for Office 365 enabled. First of all, you need to go to this URL you see right here, www.polycom.com/railconnect-trial.html. This is the URL where you are able to start your journey and get the free 30-day trial. What is important is to keep requirements in mind. So you must be an Office 365 global administrator to make sure you have full access to your tenant. Here you see the different plans and where you can enable this interop service. And of course, there's also a requirement for a Microsoft. So you need to have a minimum version of Office 2016 click to run, which is also mentioned here. But also, don't forget, which is very important, is your network environment must allow connections outside. So if you've got business partners or customers who wants to be able to connect to this service, which is part of the Office 365 service, they must be able to connect to the internet. Using SIP, H323, it doesn't matter. All the different dial instructions are in the invitation. So how do you start your journey? So as soon as you go to this URL, you see here below, get your free trial. So let me click on it and start this journey so you're able to experience different steps. So first of all, you're redirected to a webapp.plcm.vc. Because what you first need to do is you need to authorize the Polycom RailConnect Cloud Service as a CSP partner. This is just a one-time thing. This will get licensing services in there, because you will attach, like any other licensing from Microsoft in Office 365, attach a license to the users who's going to schedule the meetings. So here you click on the link right here to go to the next step and authorized. So let me click on it. So it will ask access to accept access for the tenant right here. So access the directory. You click on accept. And now you move to the next step. So here you see I want to authorize, and I have here a demo tenant for myself, and I want to authorize this where Polycom can be a CSP, a cloud solution provider. And as I said, this is a one-time thing to get the option available, which I will show you later, to attach a license to a user, just like you do with any other license. Let me click on authorized. Just follow the steps here. We sign in, see on the left side. So now I need to sign in to my tenant to make sure I got this delegated. Okay, so I'm accepting here Polycom as a cloud solution provider. Let me say yes, authorized CSP, and this will make the changes in my tenant in Office 365. And afterwards you can remove this. It's just a one-time thing. So now accepted. Successfully accepted the delegated administration offer. So close. So here you refresh the page, and here you see Polycom is now added as a cloud solution provider. And we can remove this later on. There's no problem, but I will leave it. So you can find that right here under partner relationships. So now Polycom is authorized as a CSP inside the tenant. Now we can activate a 30-day trial on this tenant. So we click again on free trial. This will bring you again to the web app. And now what you see here is you have now the portal here where you can fill in all the information, because Polycom is now a cloud solution provider. You can start the 30-day trial. So what you do here is, as it says in the above, you can enter trial 30 to start the 30-day trial. So what I do here, I fill in trial 30. We fill in first name, so let me fill in my name, Guillaume, last name. So you fill in all the information, including the trial 30 with all the other information. You go to accept read agreement, click on submit. So what will happen now is we'll add the 30-day trial in the tenant. It will check all the settings, and after this it should give me a quick summary of all the information that will be added to the tenant. Just wait a bit here. Okay, so now you see all the information available. The SIP URL, URI, which I can dial. See my license, which is activated here till Friday the 15th of September. It's a 30-day trial. I get in my trial 5 licenses, and that means I can assign 5 licenses to 5 users in my tenant, and it means also there's a maximum of 5 devices which can join the call. So 5 interrupt devices which can join the meeting. Now click on manage assignments. This will bring me to my Office 365 portal, I think very known, and to all the Office 365 admins. So first here on the top, you see my licenses, and below, which is added now, is the Skype video meeting interrupt. So if I go now to, for example, user, to activate the user, if I go now to add a user, let me say interrupt user. Right, let me call this interrupt. Okay, now what you see below is after the assignments I get the license, so I can assign now interrupt licenses, and I can assign other licenses which needs to be added. So after the license is assigned to a user, we will have the following workflow. It completely follows the line of a Microsoft workflow to schedule a meeting. So you go in your Outlook. The difference is that there is an extra line here. When you punch the Skype add-on, you will get additional instructions for a video endpoint to join a meeting. So you punch here, for example, the SIP dial string. You have here the conference ID, which you punch in to join that specific meeting. And it's not the same as your audio conference ID. That is different. So this is purely for audio participants who wants to join. And here you see a separate conference ID for the video participants who wants to join. There's also alternative dial instructions if you got a H323 endpoint. I guess any endpoint could work as long as you can get out on the internet and dial into the meeting as H323 or SIP, then it should work. There's also the one touch dial. So if you got a Cisco endpoint, RealConnect for Office 365 supports the one touch dial function. You can just punch the join button, and this will automatically dial directly into a meeting. So this is especially if you have that option available on your Cisco endpoint, that it might be really interesting to use that. of course, on the Polygon endpoints, Real Presence Trio, Group Series, HDX, we support the One Touch Dial. So walk into the meeting room and you just punch the join button and you can join the meeting. The familiar workflow in the Real Connect world. So after you've joined the meeting, so what you will see in the Skype meeting, you will see your VTCs. So your VTCs will be right here in the top. They will join as video as participants in the gallery view. But also, what is interesting, if you have any telepresence system, which could be a Cisco or Polycom telepresence system, Office 365, RealConnect Office 365 enables also that panorama view. So in the panorama, you will get the view of the whole room, which of course is a very, very interesting integration that we have if you look at the work we do together. On a standard-based endpoint, of course, you will see here all the Sky for Business clients popping up, so you have them all available, with, of course, a maximum of 5, because Sky for Business, of course, has 5 participants in the gallery view, and this is also exactly the same behavior on a standard-based endpoint. Content is also supported. So if you have any content which can be RDP, if you fall back to more older clients, or in the newer clients, there's also VBSS supported, video-based screen sharing, which has some higher frame rate, that is also supported in this service. So you can really can use up the latest sharing technologies, bidirectional, in this environment. An important item to highlight, which I was mentioning before, which I really wanted to raise, is if you're going to use RealConnect for Office 365, the video interop service, make sure you have your firewall ports open to dial out, or have something like VCS Expressway, Polycom RPAD, or a VBP video border proxy. You need to have something to dial out, because most customers have private VPN or have lease lines or anything. And in this case, the RealConnect for Office 365 is out there on the internet, and you need to dial out to the data centers from Microsoft. So this means you need to go and dial over the internet, which will require really some firewalls or routers which understand the H323 SIP protocol. So you can use those devices from Polycom, or you might already have something. But it's important. Right firewall ports needs to be open, etc. Now, what you can do, and what I recommend, is there is a test number available. And before you start any 30-day trial, make sure you can at least dial this number. Because as soon as you activate the trial here, the trial will start. The 30 days will count. Because otherwise you start troubleshooting your internet connectivity, etc. And lose days to test the service. Yeah, and lastly, which I wanted to mention, we have a portal from Polycom, RealConnect for Office 365 online support, where you find endpoints that we've tested, understand dial instructions, licensing. So I would recommend to really browse around there and see what other tips and tricks are to use this service. But it's pretty easy, and that's where it's made for. Pretty easy to start using it. Get on the 30-day trial and use the service. And if there are any questions, please let us know, of course, or your local Polycom representative.